So guys, in the last video we show the proof of the relationship between theta and the error, and it generated us a graph like this. So in the last video we saw how you can generate this graph. If you want to watch them, then please go and check out my last video. I will give the link in the description. So now today I want to tell you how you are going to update your thetas. That is how you are going to update your theta 0 and theta 1. This is the main task of today. So this is the main task of today, and let me just give you an overview about gradients. Gradients. Okay, now gradient is a fancy way in machine learning of saying derivatives. Derivatives. Now, what are derivatives? Basically, we use differentiation to find derivatives. Okay, and what are derivatives? Derivatives is used to see the behavior. Let's take this example again. This is error, this is theta 1. So with derivative we can see how error is going to change if we will change the value of theta 1. Derivative is a method that is used to check whether how the value of error is going to change when you change a very small amount of theta 1. Okay, now if you want to learn more about derivatives, then you should go and check out this video, and this video is wonderful. I have already mentioned it. I will give a link in the description for you to check it out, but you have to check this video out necessarily if you want to know more about derivatives or how you are going to do derivatives in machine learning basically. So if I talk about here right now, if you don't want to watch that video, so let's just take this idea. That let's take, we have for this point, this is, we have this point, okay, and let's take we have this point. So because we have two points, we are seeing that for this theta 1 our error is this, and for this theta 1 our error is this. So we can see that how this theta 1 is changing the value of our error. Okay, now the question is, now the thing is that you can draw a line using these two points. Okay, that is good, well and good. And if you will decrease these two points, let's suppose this is theta 1, theta 2, and let's suppose you will take a point like this, which is very, very, very close to the previous point. So in general, you can represent that point as a single point, and still you will be able to pass a line through that. Or let me just draw with this color. You can pass a line from that point. So the derivative of error for us in this function is going to be the slope of this line. Slope. So basically, what we are doing here, we are going to find the slope. And I hope that you understood the concepts here, but if you didn't, then please go and check out the other video that I have given the link in the description. That video will clear all of your doubt, and that is basically calculus, so you have to learn that by yourself, and it is not very hard, so you can do that by yourself. It is not a big deal. Okay, so now this is basically, now we got that. Okay, so the derivative is our slope of this line, and this slope can be a number in negative to positive, and you will explain, I will explain you what these numbers are exactly. So let's rub this and talk about gradient descent. Now we know what a gradient is, so let's talk about gradient descent. Basically, gradient descent is a method to decrease the value of a function iteratively. So what we are going to do, we have this slope, and let's suppose we have our error here. Okay, so in the first step we are going to update our theta, so we will get our next error here. In the next step we will update our theta again, so we will have here, then again, and we will repeat this step until we achieve this point. Now the question arises is how we are going to update these values. So theta 0 and theta 1. Okay, now theta 0 and theta 1. So what I am going to do is I am going to say whatever the value of theta is, I am going to do this theta 0 minus n into gradient of theta 0 and theta 1 minus n into gradient of theta 1. Let me explain you now. So you know what this theta 0 is. This is our normal theta that we want to update. What we are going to do is we are going to use this function to update our values. So let's see what these values are. First of all, you know this theta 0, then minus n. N is the learning rate here. So as you can see here, we have jumped from this position to this position. We have jumped from this position to this position. So for to increase this value, we use learning rate. If you do not use learning rate, then gradient is going to be very, very slow and it will take you too much time to come to this point, to this point. So that's why we use a learning rate, and you will see how you can improve this learning rate to improve the results. Okay, and then we will find the gradient on the basis of theta 0. So as you can take this as error, you can take this as theta 0, and on the basis of this, you are going to get your derivative, or you are going to get your gradient that is going to be a negative number. So let me just tell you one or two more things. So if we have this graph, and let's take we are finding the gradient, and as I told you earlier that the gradient is nothing but the slope of the line. So let's take we have a slope like this here at this position. So let's take we have a slope like this. So this slope will have values of negative, in something negative. It can have anything, any value, but it is going to be a negative value. I will explain you why these numbers are negative. Okay, now again, so what it is going to do, negative and negative, it is going to basically increase the value of theta 0, because theta 0 minus, and this is going to be some minus number, let's take minus n, so it is going to be theta 0 plus n. So it is ultimately going to increase the value of theta 0. Okay, now if you must be thinking that why would error will start from here or this point, so you can take this point. Let's take this point. Let's suppose error is here, and now if you will find the slope of this line, this is going to be like this, and now the slope is going to be a positive number. So what it is going to do is theta 0 minus, or it is going to be some number, let's take n. So ultimately it is going to decrease the value of theta 0. So this will move towards here. Similarly, same with theta 1, and that is how you can update your value of theta 0 and theta 1 with the gradient of the error. And you will understand all of this once we will see the code. So this is the maths behind the linear regression, and in the next video we will see the code, and we will implement linear regression from scratch using gradient descent. So stay tuned for that. So now I forgot one thing, is that when you will decrease these values, so let's suppose how you are going to stop this value at theta 0, basically how you are going to how you are going to get, stop your value when there is the minimum error. So let's suppose you get to this point where the slope of line was this. So this slope of line is going to be zero. Now what it is going to happen is when you will theta z, so when you will do apply this formula, so it is going to be theta zero minus n into, and as the slope of the line is zero, so it is going to be multiplied by zero, and theta zero is going to be again theta zero. So you are not going to update it once you will reach this position. So this is very good, like you can find your minima for this function, and it is not going to increase or decrease after once it will reach the minima. So this is very good. Now also let me explain you why the values of this was negative, or why the values of this side slope was positive. And it is not going to be necessarily minus 1 or minus 2, it can be anything in negative or positive. So let me just give you an example. So why was this happening? So as I told you earlier, the slope of the formula, the slope of the line has the formula y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So now if you will take, if you will apply this formula, the first value you have to take as x1 and x2. So in this case, this will be x1, x2, and in this case, this will be x1, x2. So if you will multiply all x1, y1, sorry, x1, y1, and x1, y1, and this will be x2, y2, this will be x2, y2. Okay. So if you will apply this formula and you will minus from these values, and you will minus these values from these values, then it is going to generate a positive result. You can apply that formula by yourself, it is not a big deal. And if you will minus these values from these values, then you will have a negative result. So that is going to be somewhat like it is going to have some negative result. And if you will have a straight line like this, so why this will have a slope of zero, because y2 and y1 will be equal. So y, let's take this is 2 and this is 2, so 2 minus 2 is going to be 0, and whatever the value of x2 and x1 will not matter. So this is the completion of linear regression, and I hope that you understood all the concepts here. If you have any questions, then please drop your comments in the comment box, because it is very hard to explain someone when there is no cross questioning. So I did my best, and I am sure that you will understand it if you will watch it once or twice. So now in the next video, I'm going to find the derivatives, or find the gradient, basically you can say gradient of theta 0 or theta 1. Not the gradient of theta 0 or theta 1, but we are going to find the gradient of the error on the basis of theta 0 and theta 1. So I will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.